you may not be able to see the hope, my friends. And it's a curse. Oh. It's a generational curse. Thank God for the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let me tell you how the blood works. If you have faith in the blood, don't just say, the blood. No. If you believe in the blood, that's what gives you the ability to repent. The blood of Jesus gives you ability to repent and to get cleansed of the iniquities of your generations, only if you confess it. Because look at your life. If I'm speaking to you tonight, you've already bent you. Instead of carrying the banner of Jesus on your head, the banner is carried on your back. You are not walking fast. The weight is slowing you down. You have to move at the speed of the Holy Ghost. Galatians chapter 3, please. Some will blame their wives. They get so angry with their children. They get angry with everybody. Who are you to be angry with another person? Who caused such trouble? Come to God and God will come to you.
Amen.
Come to God. Don't just come to church. Come to God.
Amen.
Come to God, my friends. Look at what verse 10 there. Galatians 3:10. For as many as are of the works of the law are under the curse. Look at that. Once you are under the law, you are under the curse. For it is written, curses everyone that continueth not in all things which are written in the book of the law to do them. But that no man is justified, look at that, by the law in the sight of God. It is evident, for the just shall live by what?
Faith
in what? In the blood. The efficacy of the blood. What the blood of the cross did. That is why you must be a messenger of the cross or you are not preaching. And this is the message. And the law is not of faith, but the man that doeth them shall live in them. Hatred is the law. Hatred. The law will make you hate me. The law is tit for tat. Slap me and I will slap you. Grace say, they slap you, forgive those who slap you. Grace say, love your neighbor. Love your neighbor as yourself. Grace say, love your enemies. That's why in this house, we have to pray for people first before we attack the devil. Because if the devil is using any person, if you keep attacking the devil, they will be affected. Is that not true? Look at that thing. I love it. Say, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. How many of you understood what that Bible says? Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. And you quote it every day. Let me tell you what that says. The law is a being. The law is a being. And the law has ability to put a curse on anything. Amen?
Amen.
Policeman is what? It's the law. Policeman. American police. Dallas police. I mean, where are we now?
Atlanta
police. Atlanta police is a law. The law of the city of Atlanta. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen?
So when you violate the law, they will put a cross on you. How? They will arrest you. A cross is something that binds you from movement.
That's right.
Are you listening now?
Amen.
For instance, you break red light. I mean, you cross the red light. And the policeman goes, ma, drive here. If you like, keep saying, please now, forgive me, I didn't know. Please forgive me. No. You have broken the law.
and is going to release what you call the cross of the Lord. Amen? Now, to every way you can set yourself free there, His grace is available to overtake the law.
Amen.
Because grace is higher than the law. Amen, sir.
Amen.
And grace will always be available where there is law. Get that? Anywhere you see law, grace is there. Anywhere you see trouble, grace is there. Grace functions more where there is trouble. And grace is the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible says the cross that the Lord put on you has been removed or has been taken by Christ, which means Christ took your place and gave you His own place. So, now that that is done, it is on paper and it is settled in heaven. But for you to enjoy it, you have to apply it to your life. Apply it to your generation.
Amen.
So tonight we are going to break what I call generational curse.
Amen.
I will not allow generational change to stop you.
Amen.
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 Because there is what we call generational blessing. And Sister Ruby, they are two people, right? They are two different people.
Yes.
While they are two different people, they may be sitting together, but they have two different minds. Amen?
Amen.
Now, this is the way the devil works. If the devil come to Shona and say, tell her something, if Shona is weak, the devil controls that weakness. Okay, I'll do it. And then the power of the enemy that controls her begin now to force this one to do the same thing that he wanted her to do. Did you get what I'm saying?
Amen.
It's all about control. Now let me tell you, anything that is controlling you negatively shall be destroyed.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
When you keep listening to friends, people so-called friends, even in the church, I'm telling you, you will sink.
Amen.
Listen to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, some of you that did not travel to Dallas, what I was praying for you was that, because I have a flash in my mind, and I say, this person will be on that last day. And people will be prepared. But towards the end of the gate, something moves you out. Unknowingly, you may think, oh, it is this reason, it is this, but I'm telling you, it is not. That thing we had this year, it's one of the most powerful conventions I've ever had. Amen. The blessing was on. Why should I, as a GO, tell you, everybody get to Dallas? And you disobey that command. Oh, my pastor, don't you know I don't have money? My pastor, there are people that came there without money, and God took care of them.
Amen.
They didn't have money. And God took care of them. Anything I do, as I'm led by the Spirit of God, is for your own good. Be careful of nearness to substance syndrome. Be careful. Don't take life like the way you think you should. Kneel down and reject the devil's handwork. Any anti-authority
is about to see.
Amen.
Be careful. Do you know that when you focus too much on job, do you know it's a generational curse? It is. That's the curse working. That's how your generation walk without anything. Nothing to go so happen. What did they leave for you? You can't be said that. Every day is for the team. One day is for the owner. And say, hey, God will say, I am healing your team today.
Amen.
Do not forget the day that God is prepared to set you free.
Amen.
Through your leadership. The blood of Jesus paid your release.
Amen.
Indeed. Paid for your release from the prison of iniquity. Iniquities of your forefathers has been paid for.
Amen.
So the devil should not use it against you.
Amen.
If he used it against you, you will know. So tonight we're going to enforce it.
Amen.
You must recover yourself.
Amen.
Please say amen.
Amen. Amen.
You must recover yourself.
Amen.
Any hole, generational hole, generational places where they kept you bound, you must recover yourself.
Amen.
Oh, this is what happened to Auntie Antoinette. This is what happened to Auntie Rebecca. This is what happened to Auntie this, Uncle this, this one. Please, your name is not in their book.
Amen.
I said your name is not in their book. If Auntie Rebecca was there, your name is not Rebecca. You are now under a new father. Your father does not have a curse. So you must apply your blood. Look at this dangerous statement. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 26. Somebody say, this is my turn. I'm going to preach this series for quite some time. There's another bang one that I'm bringing tomorrow. You get to stay in this and let's attack this generational thing and see whether the blessing of Abraham will not make us what God says. Come on, let me hash out a better here.
Amen.
What is this? And that they may recover themselves out of the snare of the devil, who are taken captive by him at his will. There are so many people that the devil can impose their will on them. Do you know where the devil can impose will on you easily? Number one, sex. Sex is powerful. If you are not careful, you can't fight sex with your brain power. You cannot. I don't want. It's not true. When you are caught in that web, that's why you shouldn't go near it at all. And maybe that time you'll be keeping yourself for 2 years. The day you are about to have sex, maybe that's the day you have with somebody that carry AIDS.
Yeah.
Yes! Yeah. Right. It's a trap! Another powerful thing is money. Money is powerful. And if you don't take time, you can lose your relationship with God because of money. The third one I want you to take note of is position. Position. When you are position oriented, everything about you, I got to occupy this position. They must not take my position from me. They are fighting me because of my position. You may lose your relationship with your Heavenly Father. Let me tell you this. The only
person that can remove you from your position this house is me.
Amen. Amen.
Not anybody.
Amen.
It's me. There is nothing that Green or Elena or anybody can tell me about you that I will do unless I am convinced by the Spirit of God. That it's time for me to change you. So don't be fighting for position. Just relax. Relax. I don't operate on her hearsay. In fact, the more people tell me about you, the more I love you. It's always the opposite. You go and ask anybody that comes to talk about you, that's where I will put my attention on you. Because I know that the reason why that person is talking about you, there's something about you. The person is helping me to get the revelation of you. I've been there now, I know. You think that God doesn't give me a position for nothing? The Jew of churches is not for nothing. Before he put me there, he has equipped me. No man will talk against you if something is not in you. There is something they are afraid of. Why was Saul after death? He knew David was going to get the throne. I got to kill this guy quickly now. But because God was with David, he failed his command. And he even prayed David, he said, you are better than me. Your enemy will say you are better than him.
Amen.
God is a God of multiplication. And I'm telling you, there is a generational multiplication that should be upon your lives.
Amen.
I remember the days of the Lord Jesus Christ, how he multiplied. Businesses, handles of bread, multiplied. Why? There is an anointing of generational multiplication upon him. The same blessing of Abraham, that was of Abraham, he came to Jesus on that day, and Jesus spoke to the bread. Bread, go and feed 5,000 people. Bread, yes, sir. How can a tree hear Jesus? If a donkey can hear Jesus, a tree can hear Jesus, bread can hear Jesus, you think you don't have the same blessing that will make them hear you?
Amen.
And as soon as they hear you, they must obey you.
Amen.
He says, Satan shall submit themselves unto you. The evil one shall fade away from the hiding places.
Amen.
The rational causes hiding in your life to get the way escape.
Amen.
Tonight. Psalm 71, verse 21. Read for me if you saw it. Read for me if you saw it.
I will also praise thee with a psaltery.
Yes.
Even thy truth.
Psalm 71, verse 21.
Oh, thou shalt increase my greatness.
Increase my greatness. So every day you wake up, angels are available to increase your greatness.
Yeah.
Stop cheapening yourself. When the religion causes are broken today, I want you to wake up in the morning under this anointing and see multiplication.
Amen.
How many of you did little biology at least little? If you didn't do it, me, I didn't do it much, but I did little. How many of you did at least little biology? Okay, professor. My mother, there is something we call amoeba. You remember amoeba? What did they do? If you put an amoeba here, before you know, the whole place is full of amoebas. Boom, they break. Right? If amoeba can multiply, what is wrong with you? Amen, church. And don't let any man of God somewhere. I know some of you go and listen to some people, and I'm not against it. But what I teach you is hung. It's completely divine.
Amen.
Somebody, don't worry. How can they say you have a curse? Yeah, you don't have a curse. Why are you not moving forward? There is unseen force that you must break.
Amen.
Because they don't know it. Let them keep their mouth shut.
God's mouth. Have a blessing. And listen. You can open a tap and you hear it. And you can open another one and you hear tum 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 tum. Why? It's blocked. The one that is not blocked, you just open it. Under 2 minutes, your pocket is full. The one that is blocked, you will spend 25 years before the pocket full. Please look at it. I give you that analogy. If a lineage is blocked, the struggle continues. When a lineage is free, there is no struggle.
Amen.
It comes easy.
Amen.
It comes quickly. Let me tell you, there is a plane that has been released now.
Yes.
A plane. It will go between here and London. Less than 1 hour. America to London is 88 hours. 8 hours. And a plane to move from here less than an hour. Check how many. What is the speedometer at which it's flying? And let me tell you this. The realm of the spirit is parallel. When you discover something in the physical and you use it and it's working, it is existing for children of God.
Amen.
You can move at the speed of light.
Amen.
Let me show you something about this ministry. Before I started this ministry, I had a vision. I was in Nigeria. And I already know about the vision, but I've not. No. I've started here. So I went to Nigeria after I started here. And when I got there, I had a dream, a vision. In that vision, I was given a Concorde jet. You know Concorde?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I was given Concorde jet to fly. And I said, and I don't drive anything. So, but I was given in the spirit, and I said, "You are the pilot." And that Concorde was—I've never seen plane as big as that. And the mouth was like this.
Yeah.
Then they gave me time. They said, "The speed of this plane is too high. There are principles you must follow."
Yeah.
The plane was packed to the brim with people. I would look back like this. I was scared. Somebody was supposed to be at my right hand, and I was waiting for the person. Come in, let's go. Come. You know, really. I said, come in, let's go. The person was there. They just closed the door, and they asked me to fly. I flew that jet under how many minutes? I got to my destination. And when I got there, I landed it. Not quite long, I woke up from that dream. That was the first day in the history of Nigeria that Concorde flew into Nigeria. Because Concorde cannot enter Nigeria. It's too big.
Mm.
But it landed in Nigeria that day.
Oh.
That was the year 1999. God is speaking. Anytime God speaks to me, He speaks to me internationally, He speaks to me locally, and He speaks to me on an individual basis. When Bill Clinton was about to be impeached, I was given a special prayer to pray for him. And I was told what would happen. That he would not be disgraced. And I said it to people around me. I said, God showed me that Clinton will be free. And it sadly came to pass. God has told me about this election, but I'm not going to tell anybody. What I will tell you is that go out and vote your conscience. I'm not going to tell you who to vote for. Just make sure you go out and vote your conscience. Because you know what? This election is extremely important to what the angels will do on earth in this 2013. You will know I'm a prophet of God. The nations of the entire world are going to gather their money and bring it to America.
Amen.
America will become one of the super richest nations in the world again.
Amen.
So you are not to fear about all this. No, God said, I chose America for a purpose.
Amen.
He told me this. And he said, keep preaching what you are preaching, empowering the people, for a time will come where they will see the truth that you are showing them. And everybody in America will begin to rise.
Amen.
That will be dangerous. In the Middle East, Lebanon may be at war. And this war that is about to happen in Lebanon will be a war that will affect a lot of things in the world. Lebanon is a very small nation, but it's